Hello, let's learn about public policy towards monopolies. So we've established here
Sure.
monopolies are not necessarily good for the consumer. You get lower quality often, and you get less quantity in the market. There's a deadweight loss, and you often experience higher prices. So the question is what to do about it. Can the government do anything, and should the government do anything? So here are some examples of what we could do. So the part of American law and European law that deals with this is called antitrust law. So in the 1800s, there were these big, powerful anti-competitive trusts, owned a lot of different kinds of companies, and so the that was a relatively new thing since the Industrial Revolution started, right? So the United States passed the Sherman Antitrust Law, or Act rather, and the Clayton Act, and these sought to either break up monopolies or make sure they weren't doing anything anti-competitive, right? So any anti-competitive behavior falls under antitrust law. So you want to pay attention to this as a business leader, right? Example again is AT&T, right? It was broken up into several companies. It's been getting bigger though, and so part of antitrust law is approving mergers. So a number of years ago, AT&T tried to buy T-Mobile. The U.S. Antitrust part of the Justice Department said no because they said T-Mobile is too much of a competitor in the wireless market, and they compete on price. They compete with different strategies, and they don't want to lose that from the market. So they said no. So they do have the power to approve or disapprove of mergers. Okay. Another one. Oops. Let me fix this slide here. There we go. That's terrible. I missed one. Sorry. Turn from a different color here. Another one they could do is do what's called regulation, right? So they will regulate the price. They'll set the price at maybe average total cost, maybe set the price at profit maximization, anything like that. In the state of Arizona, this is all run by the Corporation Commission. So anytime Tucson Electric Power wants to change the prices, they have to go before the Arizona Corporation Commission and ask. And there's a hearing, and it's some small minor hullabaloo. They're often approved, which is frustrating for some folks who don't think that the prices should be always rising, but I guess get involved in your government there. As I said earlier, they could break up large firms. One of the questions right now is, should the government get in there and break up Alphabet or Google, right? Does Google use its search to sell products, right? Should they not be allowed to sell products? Should that be a different company? Should the YouTube division be a different company? Should Google Docs be a different company, right? And Google's argument is that they give so much product away at no cost to the consumer that they're actually good for the marketplace. Okay, but other folks, especially in Europe, are saying Google is leveraging their market power into other things, right? So the very old argument, here's old Teddy Roosevelt busting up a trust and a railroad and all of that, breaking up companies. Okay, we've already had government ownership. Right, and it's not quite as efficient, but could do that, take away the profit motive, and then finally, we could do nothing. The government doesn't always get involved in a monopoly. So, for example, about 12 years ago or so, the major social networking platform was called MySpace. People were on it. Lots of people were on it. They were pretty much the dominant one. The government didn't do anything about it. Eventually, people walked away, went into different things, Facebook, and kind of where we're at now. It's a little bit more competitive, but the government didn't regulate MySpace. They didn't break them up, and now they're just kind of an afterthought of the beginning of social networking. Okay, another example would be iPods. Okay, for a couple years, Apple had a basically a technological monopoly on MP3 players, and then other firms started making them, and now you don't even own one. You probably listen on your phone, right? So what's going to happen with Google? What's going to happen with Facebook? It might be nothing, right? So this is the current track taken by the Justice Department. So these are some things we can do in terms of public policy. You should definitely pay attention to them if you run a company because, well, you don't want to do things that are anti-competitive and get a phone call from the Justice Department, anti-competitive department. Thank you.